Welcome to episode 1 of our Japan Alaska vlog series with Cunard. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. Our first day in Japan pre-cruise was off to a very fun start. The next day, we set out to learn the history of an iconic Japanese brand. Empty cups are purchased here to be soon decorated. From today.
June 18th.
With our cups decorated, it was time to select the fillings.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Yeah.
お召し上がりください。
The final step is to protect the bags for transport. In the theater, a film is shown depicting the invention of cup noodles. After Cup Noodle, we visited the historic red brick warehouses. The Osenbashi Terminal is used by most cruise ships, though Queen Elizabeth will use a different one in a few days' time. There are multiple travel cards used throughout Japan's national rail system. The Welcome Suica card does not require a deposit, though it has a 28-day validity period from first use.
The train is arriving on track 2.
列车即将抵达二号线.
We are here visiting Senso-ji Temple during what turned out to be a festival. On the third full weekend each May, portable shrines, parades, and lots of sake come together to create the Sanja Festival, held to celebrate the three founders of Senso-ji Temple, who are enshrined here in the nearby Asakusa Shrine.
ありがとうございます。
After the parade, we tried the local food and drink, beginning with boba lattes. While lattes can come in many flavors, it's the boba pearls inside that make them unique.
I should have asked, but are you okay with the milk?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mick. Do you have a trash can for the...
I have a brown sugar latte with little... What are they called?
Boba.
Boba's in them.
And?
I haven't tried it yet.
Itadakimasu. Mm-hmm. Tapioca pearls.
Yum!
This is the same thing, that tapioca pearls?
But
and
it's
a mango.
Mango juice. Yeah.
That's interesting.
We'll get some.
The 500.
Chicken?
Chicken on a stick. Ooh, those are big pieces of chicken.
Definitely thighs.
Holy cow.
Verdict?
Very tasty.
We have approval.
Ueno Zoo covers 35 acres and has over 3,000 animals from 300 species. Thank you. When the seals heard the keeper's gate open, they knew it was feeding time, though one would have trouble holding on to his snack.
That came out from his mouth, right?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how cold that water is for them.
You're kind of playing King of the Mountain or something.
The next day, we returned to Tokyo. Colorfully known as the Shibuya Scramble, the world's busiest intersection has 3,000 pedestrians cross at a time and can be viewed from in the station window just ahead, as well as the Starbucks at left you'll see in a bit. Along with rail transport, a Suica card can also be used to purchase food and for admission to certain parks and museums. The next day, we visited one of the most iconic forms of anime, Pokemon.
Doors are open.
Pokemon Center is not only about every imaginable Pokemon in stuffed animal form, but it also sells snacks, stickers, socks, and other clothing. But for not showcasing museum-like history, this would be Pokemon heaven. On our last day out before our cruise, we explored Japan's maritime history, visiting two attractions in Yokohama. Welcome aboard Nippon Maru, a ship built specifically to train Japan's sea cadets.
There are about 1,300 different kinds of rope, with a total length of 19,000 meters. Every morning, the crew and the guests flush the deck with seawater, sprinkle sand, and is scrubbed down with coconut husk. It takes about 1 hour to clean the ship.
ここは千秋楼甲板です。黒い大きな怒りがありますが、これは旧式の怒りで、現在の新しい船のものとは形が違い、怒りを入れるのにもたっぷりの人手がいます。
不問なところにロープを巻きつけ、ワンを差し込み、その力で回して使います。ウェルデッキは、営業公開中には洗濯をする場所としても使われます。毎週土曜日の午前中、全員が交代で洗濯をし、大切な真水を節約するために、20人に対して洗濯を4つの割合で水を漏れて、
2 levels lower are main tanks, some with 200 tons of fuel.Others with 500 tons of fresh water. 700 tons of copper and iron lie on the tank as base of the lab, freeing a total of 1,400 tons.
Not too bad quarters at all for a ship from the 1930s.
Sitting at the center of the table, and officers engage in discussion and conversation as they dine.
From deck seamanship to medicine to engineering, navigation, communications, and more, it's been fascinating to see how the crew lived and trained in the mid-20th century.
This is the aft navigation bridge. And, as mentioned earlier, it is from here that the ship is steered when using its sails. Although this far aft, forward visibility is not the best, the sails can be seen very well. This is very important because the ship's course is set by observing the wind.
We hope you've enjoyed this video. In our next episode, we board Queen Elizabeth and explore the northern Japan port cities Aomori and Otaru. We have lots of cruise content on our channel, so why not watch another video after this? Thank you for watching.